as if you have a choice. I would skin you alive if you bring back any useless result.
Hey, Sasha's kidnapped.
Of course.
Hey, you should have been married with me that before.
There's always a first time. You know that, right? You better be. In my face, what you're doing, and make sure you wash that meat properly. See me later. Who would you abandon that maid for?
You are my super mom. I don't think you can handle it.
Hey, tell you. Come. Who was that on the phone?
Would descend heavily on you.
Please, do not descend on her. It's my fault.
Get out. Tell that boy to leave this house.
You're very active.
How dare you talk back at me? Do you want me to give you a dirty slap? You think I'm joking?
Mom, I'm no longer a child.
Tanya. Tanya!
My dad is the one doing this. He must be very, very handsome. Hmm? Tell me about him.
Sean is just a friend.
Sean. Hmm? You know, it's usually the handsome boys that are named Sean. Kel, you know, the likes. He's not just a friend. You can tell me. I'm not like your mom.
But it's true, Auntie. Mom didn't even bother.
Come on, sweetie. There is nothing wrong with you having a boyfriend. Besides, yes, you are 17 years old. This is the stage you need to have fun, explore, take risk, so that when you are 18 years old, you are well strong enough to conquer the world. I just don't want anyone to deny your finest moments in life. I want you to explore and have affection and romance. Why? Why all the sudden somersault in presence? Where all the morals you bombarded me with when I was Tanya's age? All of a sudden you now encourage her to mess around with boys? Dad.
Take a seat,
okay? Betty, there's no need for that. Just answer me. So, Dad, I've been very stupid in life that you never gave me a chance. Is that it?
Why don't you stop forcing your daughter to leave on her? Give the girl a break.
Dad, but you are the exact person forcing her to leave under my shadows. To think you would encourage her to make the exact mistakes you tore me apart for.
Get it. All my clothes are like this. I'm talking to you.
Yes. Okay, so I take it then that everything is being checked very well. Good, remember, I told you this is very close to my heart. So, I need to double check both the right and the wrong boxes. Okay. Yeah, don't be in a rush. Take your time and check, then you get back with me. Well, young lady, you look gorgeous. So, where are we going? Ah, Sean. Okay. So, is your mother aware? Well, but you still need to talk to her. You still need her permission for such a visit.
It's Sean, isn't it?
Yes.
And you have the guts to come tell me you want to go and meet a man.
Always been there for you, you know that.
But why is she always antagonizing me when it has to be
sex? Sweetie, don't tell me you don't know why. You do know the circumstances surrounding your birth and how come you both end up under my care.
I know.
That's quite right. But tell me, this Sean boy, tell me about him. You seem to like him.
I knew it. I said it.
Eh? I knew you were lying. That he was not just a friend. I talk him. Eh? Sir?
Daddy.
Daddy.
You know how to pick the wrong time for this situation. But will you leave us alone, please?
Okay. I'm not going.
Well, you know, she's right though. She's right. You kept this relationship away from everyone for months.
There was no relationship
with
that. I just
said
realized
how I feel about that. Really? So how come? All this secrets? So you just now found a boldness. True. So have you slept with him?
That
is not an answer.
Daddy.
upstairs and pack your things. We're leaving this place right now.
Leaving?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I can't go anywhere with you now.
Tanya, I am not in the mood for arguments. Did you hear me? It's not as if you have a choice. So go upstairs and pack your things.
No, Mom. I'm no longer a child that you can be controlling anyhow.
Oh, now you can now stand there and talk back at me? You have no choice, Tanya. Go in there and pack your things. Dad, please, please, please. I will not have this with you. Please. Stay out of this.
I can't stay out of it. See, she will not go anywhere with you unless it's out of her own will.
Dad, please, I am not in the mood for this drama. I am not. I will not have you come between me and my daughter. I will not have it.
Okay. I don't know what exactly is wrong with you. Now listen to me. You take your suitcase upstairs now. I'm put on your thinking cap. You! What's wrong? Come on.
Dad. Dad. You are actually driving me crazy! Tanya! To the beach.
I hate you so much.
Jeez. Do you know what? Sean and I are in love, and there's nothing, absolutely nothing you can do about it. So start getting used to it.
I was wondering when you are going to
wake up. I slept this last night. It's a terrible headache.
Oh, Bertha. I hope you're feeling better now.
I'm not even sure.
Okay, I'll tell you what you do.
What?
You will drink a tall glass of water, then make a hot tea for yourself, okay?
Okay, but
You go make my tea first.
Okay. Daddy is ready. I don't know. She stopped speaking with me, and that helps me well.
You are comfortable with not talking to your mother?
This is going to save me from a whole lot of stress.
Now that's insolence.
But I can't force her to speak to me if she chooses not to.
Let's just say I'd rather not meddle in, you know, people's problem before people start to point fingers at me and say I'm the cause of their problem.
business.
Talk to me.
Is he really my father?
What is it? What's all that noise? And of all the way from my bed. What is it?
Sister, can you believe that God will have enough to show his face in this house? Don't know now. The matter comes out your head pregnant, remember?
What?
So he's really my father.
What
is this? I used to see him
in that. No, Tanya. You would have nothing to do with that.
It's okay, don't say that. There's no wrong in listening to what he has to say. Listen, you ladies, I am not imposing anything on you here. Well, there's nothing wrong in communication. Listen to what he has to say. See, is that why we're crying?
No, Peter, you sure is cheating on me.
Thank you. will not divorce me because they lost me on my side. So we became estranged. Last month, I found out that he welcomed my home to settle down with another woman.
Well, I'm so sorry about you guys. So, how did you find out about my story with him?
I'm sorry. I gave up my mother to get all that information. Do not mess up my life over my conscience. I think you can abandon me.
Well, I am so sorry about the mess with him. But be rest assured that my daughter and I would not want to be a part of that mess. Thank you.
Thank you.